Hi guys, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. In this particular video, I want to talk about theory of bound services. As you might be aware, in Android operating system, an app gets a dedicated process, and an app can contain any of these components like activity, service, broadcast receiver, or a content provider. An activity may want to bind to a service to get some status update. It need not be an activity always. It could be another service which might be interested in connecting to a service to get some status update. In either of these cases, the activity is trying to bind to a service, and the service which is providing the information to the activity or another service is called as bound service. And you might observe that the components which are interested in establishing the connection to the service are part of the same app, and that is why we can call it as local binding. But there may arise a situation wherein there might be two apps, and activity of one app may try to establish a connection with the service of another app. Though Android official documentation doesn't use this term, just to differentiate between the different concepts that I will be talking about, I shall use the term remote binding. I use the term remote binding because the service which will provide the necessary information to the component that is binding to it is not part of the same app, rather it is of a different app and it is a completely different process. So you can think of this as a inter-process communication. In terms of the implementation, if I can put it in a nutshell, bound services can be of two types, that is local binding and remote binding. Local binding is if the service and the other component which wants to bind to service is part of the same app process, it is local binding. And remote binding, in this case, the service and the component that wants to bind to that particular service are in two different processes. Local binding is implemented using IBinder interface, and remote binding is implemented in two mechanisms, that is Messenger API and AIDL. AIDL basically stands for Android Interface Definition Language. Messenger is basically a queued concept wherein any component which wants to connect to a service will trigger a request, and these are queued, that is they are most suited for non-multi-threaded scenario. AIDL is little bit more highly complex and it is more suited for multi-threaded environment. Android documentation clearly tells not to use AIDL. They clearly mention that most of the applications should not use AIDL, and as such AIDL is not suitable for most of the applications. That is why going forward in the future video on the bound services, I will be mainly concentrating on IBinder and Messenger API to implement the local binding and remote binding respectively. If you like the video, like, share, subscribe and comment. Take care. Bye.